We spent a lot of time in the Narrows, as I knew we would. You're in these Narrows that are 100-foot cliffs, you know, and it's narrow at times, and almost tunnel and subterranean feeling. In fact, very subterranean feeling. After riding through there, you just break out into this huge open expanse, and the Dirty Devil River comes through, and there's huge sandbars. Great sandy riding, perfect for fat bikes, and takes you right to the Dirty Devil. You can kick back a little bit and just watch these walls go by you as you slowly and, you know, smoothly work your way down the canyon. It's a very, very different experience. You get on the boat and you're just traveling through. You're more part of it, you know. It's very different, and it's really cool to combine the two. There was some serious relief when we finally made the takeout. We had no light left. There was 2 minutes left of paddling without headlamps. Dawn broke, and so all we had to do was climb up this road, 16 miles. It's kind of nice to look back and just look at your buddy and chit-chat while you're riding and talk about what you've done and, you know, and be pretty excited that you accomplished what you set out to do. You can go ride your bike and have fun, but also have an adventure at the same time. There's an objective. Yeah, we're going to climb a pinnacle. Yeah, we're going to pack raft the Dirty Devil, but you're also getting little snippets of what's up these other canyons, and they give you these ideas of new trips that you want to do. I mean, the next idea is already in my head.